She's behind the dog.
It's the early 1900s, and gawking at people who were born with deformities was not only socially acceptable, it was considered a form of family entertainment. People would travel from afar to attend freak shows exhibiting men like this one, the Elastic Man. Today we know these rare so-called beasts and freaks suffered from rare conditions and diseases. It is likely that this man suffered from Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, also known as EDS, is an inherited condition that affects the connective tissues in the body. Connective tissues are responsible for supporting and structuring skin, blood vessels, bones, and organs. The specific connective tissue that this disease affects is collagen. EDS results in a defect in collagen production. There are 13 major types of EDS that have been subtyped, but all of them have one thing in common, and that is hypermobility. Hypermobility is an unusually large range of movement in the joints. Today, we are going to focus on three major types. Hypermobility, EDS, classical EDS, and vascular EDS. The current prevalence of EDS is 1 in 2,500 to 1 in 5,000, although they think the actual prevalence may be much higher than this because the signs and symptoms can vary in severity, so they may suffer from the disease but never be diagnosed with it. Hypermobile EDS, people who suffer from it often have subluxations and dislocations of the joints. That is very common, as they occur spontaneously. They also suffer from chronic pain, autonomic dysfunction, orthostatic intolerance, which is a sudden drop in blood pressure, and bowel disorders. People with classical EDS suffer from skin hyperextensibility, abnormal wound healing, and tissue fragility. Here are some signs of them. The skin hyperextensibility is pretty, it's not your normal, like where you can just grab your skin and pull up. It's pretty severe how far they can pull their skin out. And then the most serious type of EDS is vascular EDS. People with it often suffer from arterial and organ rupture. They have soft skin, but it is not overly stretchy. You can see their vasculature very easy throughout their stomach, chest, and abdomen. Serious problems are rare while they're young, but more than 80% that have vascular EDS suffer from severe complications by the age of 40. There is signs and symptoms of the vascular EDS, whereas the other forms of EDS don't have any physical features. Children will often exhibit large eyes that are prominent, a small chin, sunken cheeks, thin lips and nose, and lobeless ears. The signs and symptoms of all EDS are thin, translucent skin. It will bruise easily. Their joints are easily flexible, resulting in the dislocations. They have stretchy, velvety skin. And the skin may also be hard to stitch if there were to be a wound or a surgical wound. And it will also result in large gaping scars. Complications of vascular EDS often result in aortic dissection, ruptures of other arteries and vessels. They have high-risk pregnancies, mitral valve prolapse, and even death. The most common complication of vascular EDS is arterial bleeds, whereas another major complication is going to be in the GI system. Some even have to have a feeding tube because the top part of their alimentary canal isn't functioning correctly anymore.
I want nuts.
Okay, there you go.
I want nuts.
In complications of classical EDS could be early onset arthritis, prominent scarring, pain, scoliosis, and prolapse of the bowel. Here are some x-rays of dislocations of the elbow, shoulder, and finger. These are going to be common in almost all types of EDS. And once they happen once, it's very common for them to happen again. Current treatment for EDS is just going to be palliative care, so it's going to be physical therapy, there's surgery to repair joints, and pain management just to minimize the chronic pain that they are always in. Prevention of injury from EDS, there is no cure, they're just going to suggest that you avoid contact sports, avoid lifting weights, and use sunscreen to protect the skin because it's already fragile. The highest risk thing with the vascular EDS is going to be pregnancy. You're going to have to seek genetic counseling before conceiving. There is a 50% chance that you'll pass those genes on to your offspring. And the most cases of EDS are honestly diagnosed with being a hypochondriac because the signs and symptoms vary so much. So we've come a long way. There's been a lot of research to develop the signs and symptoms of the disease and also help diagnose it, but there's still plenty of research left to be done.